Welcome back to the Talking Hedge. I'm Josh Kincaid, capital markets analyst and host of your cannabis business podcast. Today, we've got Lofa Tatupu, retired NFL linebacker, all pro with Seattle Seahawks, some other teams we don't care about, just the Seahawks. Now he's in charge of ZoneIn CBD. Welcome to the podcast, Lofa.
Man, thank you for having me, brother.
So you mentioned cannabis as a performance-enhancing drug. Kind of wanted you to elaborate on that. A study was published in the Current Neuropharmacology that CBD has the ability to ease both chronic and acute pain, and it does so without negatively impacting the central nervous system. And yet the World Doping Agency, since its inception in 99, has included cannabis on the list of banned substances. So considering them to meet at least two of the three following criteria that it has potential to increase or enhance sports performance represents an actual potential risk to health or violates the spirit of the sport. So today, cannabinoids are still prohibited in competition. I think the Japanese Olympics are finally this year, finally going to allow CBD. So cannabinoids are prohibited with the exception of CBD. So asking that question, like, how is cannabis a performance enhancing drug for you?
The way I interpret and process information is light speed compared to where I was post football. And, you know, as a middle linebacker, you're essentially the quarterback of the defense, and I never operated on this level of efficiency. So if I'm processing information that much quicker, how much quicker am I going to get to the spot that I need to get? Or I'm telling somebody, because that my job is to tell guys, hey, where to line up, how we're going to adjust, you know, anything could change at any given moment, and I'd have to get everybody on all 10 guys on the same page next to me, 11 total. And, you know, then I got to turn around and I got to zone in literally and do my job. And so, like, if I had this, I can't imagine how easy that would be, because the mental and emotional exhaustion from a game after, you know, it's done is way, I'd say it's probably even worse than the physical exhaustion.
You mentioned that you thought if you tried CBD earlier in your career, before you tore your pectoral muscle that ended your career in 2012, if you had tried, you know, say 2005 when you were with the Seahawks, do you think that your career would have been expanded with CBD?
I'm telling you right now, if I found it in 12 when my career ended, I would have played at least three or more years, maybe four. Wow. And I've told them, because like how good I feel, I'm telling them I could go back and like, look, I got down to 235, and because I know what it takes to get out there. And I understand I'm 37, but there's guys that have played at 37. And I understand, you know, they didn't have significant injuries that kept them, you know, that they were, you know, lucky on top of, you know, good. But they also, what I would venture to say, this is just a theory, is they had a heightened endocannabinoid system that told them, you know, that mind-body connection when they were in trouble and when to pivot or let go or get out of that position. And just as I've seen, I played with several guys that were phenomenal athletes. Bobby Wagner, for instance, he had pulled a hammy and it was bad. He played the whole rest of the game. He played the next week. Now, is he tough? Absolutely. He's a middle linebacker. But a lesser athlete wouldn't be able to adapt and tell their body how to get out of that situation successfully. Mm-hmm. And I'm saying, like, when I go to play hoops, I pulled my hammy. You know, for a split second became Bobby. But, you know, but I feel like I have that connection with my body. That's what the great athletes have. They know themselves better than anybody in terms of what they tweak. They can tell you exactly what it was, how they did it, and they can navigate without further damage. So that's why they play longer. That's why they, you know, don't get hurt as often. Knock on wood. It's my guy. And ultimately what we're talking about is what the owner should be excited about. We're talking about a better product on the field, and then also, even more importantly, in the community. Who doesn't want that? So that's what I'm excited about in terms of the future of football, in terms of, you know, just everybody.
So with that, we're going to roll this one up. I want to thank my guest, Lofa Tatupu. He's CEO of ZoneIn CBD. Thanks for being on the podcast.
All right, brother. You take care. Have a great day.
I'm Josh Kincaid. This is The Talking Hedge. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Or don't, and I'm out.